Known as Valentine's Day, and I have decided to spend this day by myself and having a very, very wholesome me time. Obviously, one shouldn't only do that on Valentine's Day. Every day should be an awesome experience with yourself, but since there's always so much expectation on Valentine's Day, I figured it would be such a nice way to just acknowledge myself and give myself some love. You know, we all need it sometimes, if not always. I also decided to put on a fancy outfit. I did my makeup, so I feel extra, not necessarily festive, but just happy. And so far, I've been having a great time. Also, the weather is really nice. I'm not planning on going outside at all, but enjoying it from inside is also very nice. I decided to film this day and maybe send you some very positive energy and maybe inspire you to spend some very lovely and caring TLC kind of day with yourself. And honestly, I'm so excited. I'm going to cook some food. I might have a dance party by myself, which lately has been amazing because it gets me through the day and makes me feel so much better if I ever have a bad day, which happens. I might also do some painting if I feel like it, some creative self-care time, which is honestly so nurturing and lovely. And also, I am baking myself a cake. This is the most exciting part because I think it will be so wholesome. Feel free to stick around and I don't know, maybe grab some cake as well, or a cup of tea, or a cup of coffee. Make yourself extra cozy, and I hope you enjoyed this sweet day with me. I just feel happy right now, and I'm sending you all of this happiness. But let's just wrap it up and start a nice day. Oh my god, and right at the perfect time, I received this package from a friend of mine who spent a semester abroad in Korea, and she had bought me all of these stuff, but because of the pandemic we haven't managed to meet up, and she sent it to me by post, and I'm actually going to cry. Oh my god, thank you so much. All right, so I think it's time to make some lunch. I am making spring rolls. I've never made spring rolls. I've only made summer rolls. And I'm not sure how the frying process will go, but we're here to try it out. Each day is Valentine's. Which one looks better? Tell me.
Welcome to Yoga with Adrienne. I'm Adrienne, this is Benji, and today we have a sweet little meditation for self-love. So hop in.
I am thinking about starting baking the cake. How does that sound? Good, I hope.
I think it's time for me to overshare a little bit and tell you why I actually wanted to film this video and why I decided to spend one day with time just for myself. Now, I've never been the biggest fan of Valentine's Day. It just never made much sense to me, and I just don't like how commercial it is, and it's pretty much capitalism's way to make money out of people either being lonely or in love or romanticizing their relationships. However, as sometimes one does, I had expectations more or less for this year's Valentine's Day, and they changed, which is totally normal and happens. But once these plans changed, it shook me big time. And I'm not only talking about Valentine's Day, but in general. And I can imagine that others can relate to that situation where you have the safety of having someone next to you. It could be that you're just talking to them, but you know it's something more than friendship. You could be dating, could be a relationship. Obviously, there's so many different stages of what kind of a communication that can be. But it is a safety feeling, especially because we live in a society where we're so often told that as long as you're not dating or you're not in a relationship, you've done something wrong, or you hear comments such as, you're too pretty to be alone. And that's definitely something I've been dealing with for a long time. I would base my self-worth on who I had in my life. And in the end, it would very often end poorly, and it would leave me feeling worse and worse and more alone. And it sucks. And it took me so long to realize that. Just such an unhealthy way to live because of what society sees or thinks or tells you you should be doing. You follow your own inner voice, but sometimes it gets difficult because at some point you may not be able to make a difference between your own voice and what society tells you. So it is quite revolutionary to be by yourself and to actually like yourself. And it was time to just say, I'm not doing this. And I'm so excited to be on this journey. And I know that it's a journey that baking a cake won't fix, or it won't help all that tremendously. A lot of us can resonate with that, but it's so difficult to actually come to the point where you're like, yes, that is exactly what I'm going to do. And I'm not expecting that you listening to me ramble about my own experience will help you figure out this issue for yourself. But I invite you to really look within and be very clear with yourself, because so often we tend to not even be honest with our own thoughts. So it's definitely a journey, I'm so excited to be that person for myself so that I don't feel alone when I'm with myself, because nobody wants that. That was my bit of oversharing. Is it possible that I will regret all of this? Yes, but it is life, honestly, so who cares if I'm oversharing? I genuinely hope, whoever you are, that you'll join me on this journey and experience, because it is so healing and it's so liberating. That's it. I'm done with this sad little TED talk, but if that resonates with you, I'm sending you lots of love. Lots of love. Okay, I'm honestly so nervous to do this. But here we go. Oh my god. Oh my god. This is the best day, honestly. The best day. I don't know how I'm gonna eat this now, but exciting.